Good morning, students. Welcome to the class. Today's date is 11th January 2021. As you know, we have been doing lesson 10, Natural Resources, the forest part. So in our last few classes, we have discussed about the definition of natural resource, what are natural resource, then the forest, and also the different types of forests. So we have come across five different types of forests that are found in India, and among them we have discussed the coniferous forest and evergreen forest. So other three types of forests we will be discussing it today. So let's move forward to the learning outcomes. So today's learning outcomes are to identify the different types of forest and to describe the features of the different types of forest. Let's do a quick recap of what we have discussed in our previous class. So the five major types of forests that are found in India are the coniferous forest, evergreen forest, deciduous forest, thorny and scrub forest, and tidal forest. So these are the five major forests that are found in our country, India. So let's discuss the coniferous forest. So these forests are found in the Himalayan and the Nilgiri mountains. The trees are narrow and pointed at the top and wider at the bottom. So this prevents snow from remaining on their branches, and the leaves are like needles, so they do not collect snow. So that is one of the significant features of the coniferous forest. So these are the pictures. I have already showed it to you in the previous class. So this is how the trees look when you go to Shillong or when you go to any other hill stations. You will find that in the mountain regions, mostly the trees are pointed towards upward, and at the bottom they are wider. Now let's come to the evergreen forest. So evergreen forests are found in the hot and wet regions of India. So trees such as eucalyptus and rosewood grow in these regions. They never shed their leaves completely and always look green. So which are the hot and wet regions of India? So this evergreen forests are found on the Western Ghats, the hills of the northeastern India, and on the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So these are some of the places where you are going to see the evergreen forest, because here in Assam also, as you can see in your surrounding, look at your surrounding, you will find that every 10 to 12 months, the trees they are in green in color. Though they shed leaves, but they still look green in color. Now eucalyptus and rosewood are some of the trees that are found in this evergreen forest. Now let's come to the deciduous forest. So these forests grow in the peninsular region of India. They are also found along the foothills of the Himalayas. Trees like Gulmohar and teak can live and grow in different kinds of weather. These trees have flat and broad leaves and require a lot of water. Hence, they lose their leaves in the dry season. Now, deciduous forests are mostly found in the peninsular region. Now, which are the peninsular region? The Central Highlands and the Deccan Plateau. And when we are studying about the Central Highlands and the Deccan Plateau, their features, the climatic features, the how the climate affects the plants, there we have got that the trees have hard wood and their leaves are broad, right? So here also, if you look at this one, it has the broad leaves and flat, so you can relate it. So peninsular, this deciduous forests are found in the peninsular region of India. They are now, along with the peninsular region of India, they are also found along the foothills of the Himalayas. Foothills means below the Himalayas. Now trees like Gulmohar is the Krishnasura, what we call in Assamese, the red flower. I'm going to show you. So trees like Gulmohar and teak can live and grow in different kinds of weather. So Gulmohar and teak, they not only they grow in deciduous forests, but other kinds of weather as well. So these trees have flat and broad leaves and require a lot of water, hence they lose their leaves in the dry season. So in the winter season is the dry season. So during the winter season, you will see that the leaves, they will shed, that they will fall down, okay? And the trees will be there only with their branches. So evergreen forest and deciduous forest, just compare it. Evergreen forest, they remain green throughout the year, while deciduous forest trees, they shed, or for the trees, the leaves fall down during the winter, and what happens? The branch, on the tree remains empty without the leaves. Okay, so you can see some of the trees during the winter season, they one or two hardly you are going to see, but if you notice it, come across it, you will see that these trees, they do not have leaves. They are only with their branches, without any leaves. So these are some of the deciduous forest. They belong to the deciduous forest, or you can belong to the deciduous forest. And the others, that the trees which have leaves throughout the year, are the evergreen forest. Now here are some pictures. The first picture is the Gulmohar, and the second is the tea. So Gulmohar is the Krishna Sura, which you are during the spring season, you will observe that it grows a lot, this red color tree. Whenever you are on a journey to somebody, to some place, you will see that on the roadside, this Krishna Sura, the Gulmohar, they flower a lot. And the next one is the teak. Now let us come to the thorny and scrub forest. When we talk about thorny and scrub forest, the name itself suggests that they are found in the desert areas, right? So which are the trees? So trees like babul and kikar are found in hot and dry areas. In India, they are found in the desert of Rajasthan and Gujarat, parts of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. The rays of the sun is very strong in these regions and the rainfall is less. So the trees and plants need to live with less water. Their leaves become thorns so that they do not lose water. Their roots are long because they have to force deep into the soil in search of water. Now, this thorny and scrub forest, mostly for example, this babul and kikar are given, they are found in the hot and dry areas. Whenever there is hot, it will be a dry area. So in India, where they are found, they are in Rajasthan, then parts of the Gujarat, then parts of Uttar Pradesh, then Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. So they have very hot and dry areas. So you are going to find these trees in these regions of India. Now why they have, they are particularly thorny? Because the sun is very strong and the rainfall is very less. And plants need water to grow. So therefore what happens, their leaves become thorns. Their structure is like thorns so that they do not lose water from it. And these particular kind of plants, they used to have very, very long roots. And they force their roots inside the soil, so that deep inside the soil, so that they can get water from below the ground. So that is why these are very, these plants are particularly found in the hot and dry areas. So here are the pictures. This the first tree is the babul tree, and this is the babul tree. And if you see, this is how the leaves look like. Just a minute. Yeah, this is how the leaves look like. Okay, so you can see these are thorns. So these trees have leaves along with their thorns. Now this is the kikar tree. So this is how the, if you can see, there are hardly any trees beside it, and it is very far, and the land is also very dry. Now let's come to the tidal forest. Now tidal forests are found where the land is flooded by seawater. So mangroves such as the Sundari trees in the river deltas of West Bengal. So we have heard about deltas. Deltas are full of water. So these trees mostly found near the water or above the water. The roots of these trees go upwards to come out of the water. They do this to get enough air. Now these roots, they are not below. They go upwards. Why? Because they need water and air. Water, they are already getting. They are above the water. So When the land is flooded by water, they are already in water and they get it. But what about the air? So for the air, they have to come out of the water. So they will, therefore their roots are upwards. I'm going to show you how the roots are. So this is how the roots look like. See, the land is already above the water and you can see that the trees, it is flooded by water. Half of the land is flooded by water and the roots, these are not below the water. They are above the water. Why? Because they are growing upwards, because they have to take air from the atmosphere. Therefore, to sustain or to grow, they need air. Water is available from below, but air, they have to take it. So their roots grow upwards. In the same way, here also you can see the tree is growing. It is just looks like an island. It is just in the center of the water and you can see the roots are up. You can see the roots till the, I'm going to zoom this one. You can see the roots are up to here. See, they are growing upwards, not below. Okay. So whenever we see the trees, we do not see the roots. They are always below the ground. But here you can see that the roots are growing upwards towards a branch. See, therefore, that is why these are called tidal forests, because they have to survive on water and they need the air as well. So these are some of the differences between the the forest, this the deciduous forest, the coniferous forest, the evergreen forest, then we have the thorny and scrub forest and the tidal forest. Read the lesson, go through it. I hope you will get it, the difference between each of the forests. It is according to the climatic conditions, these trees grow. Now let us come to the train my brain. So these are your classwork. So what types of trees are found in deciduous forests? So trees found in deciduous forests have broad flat leaves. They require a lot of water, hence they lose their leaves during the dry season. They can live and grow in different kinds of weather. And the next question is, what is special about tidal trees? The roots of tidal trees grow upwards to come out of the water. They do this to get enough air. So write these answers on your copy. I'll be sending it in the Google Classroom. As after watching the video, just write it down in your copies, because these are very important questions from the Train My Brain. So here I'm going to wrap up my class. Thank you.